Good morning, Wisconsin. Good morning, world. It's a new day. Thanks for kicking it off with us right here at 97.5 FM, 1320 AM, WFHR. We are locally grown radio. 9:04 on the clock. Got your host, James J. behind the mic. I am joined by our head of news, Melissa Kay.
Good morning.
Head of production, Seth Habhager.
Good morning.
And the best listeners in radio, all of you. Thanks so much for joining us, everybody. We've got some entertainment news coming up a little bit later. That ain't right stories. Some good stories of the day. We're going to talk about local entertainment. But right now, we're talking sports with our great friend, Mike Clemens. It's been too long, sir. Thanks for joining us.
Hi, everybody. Good morning.
Morning, Mike.
Good morning, Mike.
Good to have you with us, Mike. We are a little short on time today, so if you don't mind, sir, I'd like to focus on Badgers, and I know you were at the Combine last week. So let's start right with the Badgers, Mike. Interesting time right now for the Badgers basketball team.
Well, you know, they were on their way. They were ranked sixth in the nation just five, 6 weeks ago, and then they go into this slump for reasons I can't fully explain. But I do know that, you know, I mean, people say to me, you think Greg Gard's on the hot seat? No, he's not on the hot seat.
Yeah.
For one thing, he's got a year left on his contract. But anyway, but I'll tell you, last night's game, they get home. They've been 14-3 at home. Most of these losses have been road games. They're playing Rutgers, a team that beat them about a month ago. And they came back. They were down 47-40 with about 14 games left. And here's one of the changes. Kamari McGee, this is a guy that injured his foot about five, 6 weeks ago, and they let get him into the game, and he's a big guy, physical, aggressive, makes a steal, scores. Deflects, scores. Put up six of the next 10 points on a run that they had. And after the game, on the post-game show on the Badgers Radio Network, Greg Gard, the head coach, says, you know what, that's what we're missing. That was a spark, an aggressive style of play that we needed, that you can't necessarily drop, you know, on the clipboard with various sets, and that's what they need to do moving in. A.J. Storr had 19 points for him. Now, Sunday, they're going down to Purdue in Indiana. They're going to play the number third ranked team in the nation, probably lose that one. But at least after last night's win and the way they handled business, they're probably in a much better frame going into the Big Ten tournament next week, and then hopefully get that bid to the NCAA tournament for March Madness.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how many Big Ten teams do get that ticket, and really hoping the Badgers are one of them. I wouldn't be – the only reason I'm afraid of Purdue this Sunday is because they're ranked third. If they're ranked number one, I think we might have a chance at beating them. I mean,
right.
It seems like anytime they're at that number one ranking, Purdue wants to lose. So
We'll
have that game for you right here at WFHR on Sunday. Be sure to check it out. It's going to be a really good one. Any Big Ten matchup, especially as they get closer and closer to the Big Ten tournament. Mike, I know you were at the NFL Combine last week. Would love to know how it went, if you had a good time. And I wanted to focus on Green Bay. And what, to you, is their number one concern right now as the NFL free agency kicks off, Combine ends?
It's not whether they're going to bring back David Bakhtiari, left tackle, had another surgery on his knee and is recovering from that. It's not a question mark on the great A.J. Dillon, running back, who's ingrained himself into the community in Door County so much because they're probably going to let him go. I think they'll probably get to some sort of an agreement with Aaron Jones, their number one running back at 29 years old, because of what he showed them toward the end of the season. Your boy here, with all the stations we've got and, Packers Radio Network stations and whatnot, I get a text and I get invited into the inner circle to have a chat with Brian Gutekunst, the Packers GM, last week.
Wow.
So, they start all the press conferences after about 10, 11 o'clock Eastern time, where the GMs and many of the head coaches do it. And they say, show up to this team hotel at 8, and there's a certain conference room, and you walk in. Big table there. There's some Starbucks there off to the side. And Brian walks in at 8 o'clock sharp. They close the door. And he goes, okay, guys, shoot. And so it's 1 hour off the record. The writers can use some of those quotes, but, I can't, use a microphone. You can record just to hear it. But it's ask anything you want, and he'll go deep and give you background on things.
Wow.
And so at the end of the day, they're in pretty good shape. I even said to him, I said, Brian, you picked 13 players last year in the draft. 11 of them saw significant playing time, including all those receivers. And even Malik Heath, an undrafted guy who made the roster, saw some time at wide receiver and special teams. He said, and we played them all, see? And so they got to establish themselves. So that's why we had such what looks like such a great draft. Those guys got the opportunity to play. But he said, you know, bottom line is Jordan Love. Mm-hmm. So after they make these decisions, whether what they do in free agency, and they're not going to be big spenders at the start of free agency and spend silly money, mm-hmm. but they'll probably pick up, you know, some guys along the way, some pieces, some veterans. Then what they do in the draft, they're much more back to being a draft and develop team like they proved to the world last year. And actually, the last two drafts have been pretty good for them. And then after that dust all settles, then they'll probably sit down and work out a deal with Jordan Love, maybe May or June or so. But here's a great story. Mm. I'm introduced to a guy, and this is why you go there, because someone says, hey, you want to come to this lunch tomorrow? I meet a guy who covered the Vikings for one of the papers for many years, but he moved out to the Denver Post and has covered the Broncos the last 2 years. And so this guy introduces me to Chris and says, hey, Mike got into the Goody meeting this morning. And, oh, how'd that go? Talked about it a little bit. And I said, so what's Sean Payton like, head coach of the Denver Broncos? And he says, you know, interesting. Have you had a meeting with him? Like, yeah, well, yeah, it was last night. Oh, really? The night before everything got started. Interesting. So what was that like? He said, it went 6 hours.
Wow.
Oh, whoa. God.
6 hours. I said, well, please tell me, you were talking like fly fishing or something, right? He goes, no, it was all off the record, and it was all on football.
Like, wow.
Oh, my God.
That's
so
incredible.
I ran into Gutekunst in the hallway later in the week, and I said, hey, thanks for the hour the other day. Appreciate it. Oh, yeah, no, good, no problem. I said, a buddy of mine covers the Broncos, and Sean did his Monday night. Oh, really? Yeah. So I said, yeah, it went 6 hours, and his jaw dropped. And I said, Goody, I like you, but I don't think I could go 6 hours.
Yeah, yeah.
And he said, and then he shrugged his shoulders and said, you know, I mean, we got to sign Jordan, but after that, I mean, we're good. Like, yeah. And I wanted to slip that away just to see if he took that up to Mark Murphy and the rest of the guys. And what did they do? A week later, they released Russell Wilson.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, it's a different day now where teams before would just have to sit and eat with a quarterback for another year. Now, $84 million, we're moving on. Like, it's just a weird thing to see.
Well, also, they gave away 5 draft picks, including 2 first rounds, and 3 active players, including the tight end Font, to the Seattle Seahawks for this one quarterback. And you know something that Brian did say on the record at his press conference later that day was, listen, there's no such thing as being one player away from the Super Bowl.
Mm. Yeah, yeah.
I'm with you there.
That's a great line. That's very true. Mike, I'm really I don't want to keep you too long, sir. Your time is valuable. I appreciate you joining us. But I do have a real quick question. You know, for years, we knew the Green Bay had, for over two decades, Green Bay had were set at quarterback, from going from Favre to Rodgers. With Brett Favre, it seemed like some free agents wanted to play with him. With Aaron Rodgers, it may have been that way for a little bit there, but I always was curious, and I think we kind of got our answer towards the end of his career, his run with Green Bay, of why free agents may or may have not wanted to play with him. It just didn't seem like he got a lot of big name wide receivers looking at one of the best quarterbacks in the game like you usually would. Do you think that's going to change with Jordan Love? Could you see free agents wanting to play with him more? It seems like whenever we see him at the Pro Bowl or with other players, they just really like this kid.
I think so. And not only that, though, I would think that LaFleur looks attractive, that some of the playmakers that they... I mean, how many
the
times
franchise.
Did you see... Yep. I can think of 5 or 6 times, and you can see it watching the games on TV. How many times did you see guys wide open?
Yeah.
Musgrave, Wicks, wide open in the end zone, which means, you know, Love is running the plays as they're drawn up, and they're working. Mm-hmm. But, you know, there was one guy who was a very good defensive player. He'd been with a great team that actually had gotten to a Super Bowl, but the team moved on. They thought he was getting too old. And they released him. He was dumbfounded, this former Heisman Trophy winner, that he was on the street. So he called his agent, and the agent said, well, what do you want to do? He says, get me to the Jaguars, man. They got a great defensive front, and that'll help me out on the back end. And the guy called him back. He says, you know what? The only people that have called back are the Green Bay Packers and Ted Thompson. Oh, man, I don't want to go to Green Bay. Mm-hmm. You know, they're kind of a mess. I don't want to go there. The player was Charles Woodson.
Oh, oh. God, I love that. I'm a huge Woodson fan, man. That's an awesome story. I didn't know that. That is really interesting.
Charles told that to me.
That's such a good story.
Very cool.
That is really cool, Mike. You were invited into that meeting, sir, because you people respect and appreciate all the work you've done in this state and in the game. We appreciate you, Mike. Thanks so much for joining us. Next year, when you go to Indy, if you need a, I don't know, if you need an assistant, you know, if you're a golfer, if you want me to caddy for you, whatever you need, Mike, please just let me tag along with you. Please, please, please.
No problem, James. No problem.
Thank you, Mike. We appreciate you. Have a great day and safe travels out there.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you. The best in the business right there. Mike Clemens joining us. Yeah. We appreciate him. We'll take a quick time out. We'll check in with our partners. We'll come back and we'll talk a local theater. We're talking local arts and entertainment when we come back on the morning show at WFHR.
The message is perfectly simple. The meaning is clear. Don't ever stray too far.
Welcome back, everybody. Morning show here at WFHR. A little 80s vibe to play us in.
Yeah.
And I kind of played that for a reason a little bit, because we're going to have some fun talking music in a little bit. We'll get to that a little later.
Oh, okay.
For right now, let's touch on a little bit of entertainment news and just some interesting things to get to. So on Playmakers on Monday, we're going to talk a little more about this. But Mike Tyson is going to be fighting Jake Paul in July on Netflix. It is going to take place at AT&T Stadium or Jerry World in Dallas, the Dallas Cowboys Stadium. The fight will air live on Netflix. Tyson is 58. He'll be 58 when he steps in the ring. Jake Paul is 27. I would like to journalistically say, first off, neither of these gentlemen have a great backstory. I think that Jake Paul is one of the more scummy people in the YouTube game, influencer game. You don't have to take my word for it. That's facts. You can go ahead and look at his history and how he got his name where he did and all that. And I think it speaks for itself. Mike Tyson certainly has his, problems and troubles and everything in his past. I will say the difference with Mike Tyson, not only is he obviously older and had a chance to do this, Jake Paul has not, to be fair. Mike Tyson, I think society has decided he has paid his dues. And while we don't forgive or forget anything he has done, we have let him have the comeback story, the thing we love the most in this country. Apple pie, baseball, close second and third to a comeback story. That's what we love number one in this country. And I like that personally. I'm a comeback story. I'm not talking bad about it or anything.
Right.
I appreciate it. That being said, Jake Paul's an idiot. Like, he's an idiot. I know we're not supposed to throw words like that around and everything. Why else do we have the word if not for situations like this? Jake Paul has gotten a quote-unquote boxing career by fighting tomato cans. By fighting people, for those who don't know what that means, basically a boxer just doesn't move his arms much or anything, just sits there and takes punches. Mm. Lots of fighters make a living doing that, just taking punches, taking knockouts, being the guy who's going to be right before the heavyweight fight.
Right.
That's pretty demeaning to tomato cans.
It is a little bit. I would like to take this time to apologize to Campbell's, to all the big tomato can companies. We'll see how this goes. I'm not 100% this is even going to happen. And I'm not 100% sure that it's all on the up and up. I think Mike Tyson respects boxing and appreciates boxing. I will watch this fight, and I haven't wanted to watch a boxing fight in a long time. The reason I want to watch it is, one, seeing one of the greatest boxers of all time one more time, even at a diminished age. And two, because I want to see Jake Paul get knocked out. But what I hope doesn't happen, and I'm not even kidding about this, he could kill that kid. He could kill him, man. Yeah. Like, if all you do is watch highlights of Mike Tyson, that's fine. But for somebody who studied Mike Tyson, studied boxing and everything, Mike Tyson is a guy that would take face punches to time his it takes him this long to get to me. So I know when I could throw my uppercut. Like Ali did rope-a-dope, where his plan was, Ali goes to his camp and says, okay, this is how I'm going to beat Foreman. I'm going to spend 3 or 4 rounds letting him hit me with everything he's got and wear himself out, and then I'm going to take him in the 5th and 6th. Like, I don't know what his camp must have thought. I bet there was a lot of betting on Foreman or something. I don't know. But that's Tyson goes a step even further and is like, I'm going to take punches to time you out because I can take it. And I'm gonna knock you out, and it, like the force of a Mike Tyson punch, even at this day and age, there was a highlight reel of him working out with another boxer because he helps train other boxers. There's a highlight reel of him hitting a bag, and the bag gives up. The bag is done. The bag doesn't even want any more of this. I don't know.
It just walked off. I mean, it just carried itself off.
That is going to be interesting. We'll see how that goes. I'm curious about how that story unfolds. I want to talk a little bit about what's new on your small screen, new on your big screen this weekend. But I first want to mention, I want to get to River Kings. Let's get to River Kings. Let's talk about that, because River Kings are back in action tonight, 7 o'clock. They are in the second round of the playoffs. Keep in mind that this is a best of three series that the River Kings are playing, so that they have three nights, possibly. With hopefully wrapping it up in two nights. We're taking on the Minnesota Moose, who are the fifth-ranked team in the USPHL playoffs. If they win these games, they move on to the next round, obviously going for the championship.
Wow.
They will take on the Minnesota Squatch or the Hudson Havoc. That series will also be decided this weekend. We don't have any guarantees other than these two games here, Friday and Saturday. No matter what happens, let's make sure to show these boys, these teammates, this coaching staff, all the people working behind the scenes, everybody over at the Southland County Rec Center that does a great job, over there. Let's show every one of them how much we appreciate our River Kings. Mm-hmm. River Kings they add to the economy of this town.
They do.
They add to the energy of this town. They add to everything in this town. They take nothing from this town. All they do is give. Let's give them a home ice advantage all throughout these playoffs. Let's bring home a championship, damn it.
Wouldn't that be cool?
Let's bring home a championship. Let's do this. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go, everybody. Get to the Suffolk County Rec Center tonight, all weekend long. Support your Kings as they build hockey up and down the river. The coach and the gang, we'll see you on Monday on Playmakers. Looking forward to celebrating this win over the weekend.
We can guarantee one thing: exciting hockey.
Yeah.
We can guarantee that.
I love sports. I'm obviously a nerd about them, but I will put my name on this. There is nothing better than playoff hockey. Nothing. Nothing compares to playoff hockey. You know, believe me, go find out for yourself tonight right here in town as the River Kings hit the ice. Puck drops at 7. Find out more and get your tickets at riverkingshockey.com, riverkingshockey.com. Let's go ahead right now and talk about what's new on your small screen, new on your big screen, and then we'll go ahead and get to our news break. And when we come back, I want to talk a little bit about local theater, the Glass Menagerie, and some more. For right now, looking at what's new on your small screen this weekend, Damsel, a survivor thriller starring Millie Bobby Brown from Stranger Things.
Cool.
It's a medieval damsel who's basically, this is, I don't need Prince Charming, I got this.
That's cool. I love that idea.
It should be good. Yeah. So she's great. She's great.
Very good.
She's
like really
brilliant.
Good. Yeah.
Yep. I've really liked her signing up with Netflix, the Elena Holmes, or how do you pronounce it?
Enola
Holmes. Those were really good. Yep. Mm-hmm. Henry Cavill is really good in those, by the way. Like, you give him a chance to not have to do some action, he can act.
Yeah, he can.
Tonight on Max, the streaming premiere of Wonka is taking place. A lot of people are going to be excited about that
one. Yeah.
On Friday on Apple or tonight on Apple TV Plus, the second season premiere of Eugene Levy's The Reluctant Traveler. That's a fun little show.
I'd watch anything he's in.
Absolutely. Awesome. 100% with you, Melissa. Josh Brolin is hosting Saturday Night Live this weekend with Ariana Grande as the musical guest. And of course, on Sunday at 7, the Oscars. Jimmy Kimmel hosts. Performances from Billie Eilish and Finesse will be there. Ryan Gosling and Mark Ronson will also be performing. So, big one. That's the big one on Sunday, the Oscars. See how that unfolds.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, Robert, the only thing I'll put my money on, Robert Downey Jr. is getting that Oscar.
Yeah.
He's finally getting that Oscar, baby.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm sending him an email. And it'll go right to his spam folder.
Yeah, right. But hey, I sent it to him.
It'll go right to his spam folder, man. I don't know why I'm even doing that. And big movie in theaters this weekend, Kung Fu Panda 4. Jack Black returns as Po, who has been asked to become the spiritual leader of the Valley of the Peace. Viola Davis is in this, along with Awkwafina and a couple of other great voice actors.
Cool.
A lot of people excited about this one.
Mm-hmm.
It's Jack Black.
Yeah. And the only thing maybe more fun than the movie itself is seeing Jack Black on the promotion tour. Like, if you, whenever you get a chance to see an interview with Jack Black, take it.
Yes.
Take it.
He's fun.
There are a few people that are a better interview than Jack Black. Mm-hmm. He is awesome. I'm a big fan of Jack Black. It should be good. Should be good. Let's go ahead and there's so much to highlight this weekend, you guys. I want to make sure that we get everything in. That's the other thing I wanted to make sure to talk about. Always Olivia.
Oh, yes. Yeah. It's coming up on Sunday.
Yeah. This is a great show. We recently, it wasn't too long ago, I should say, that we lost one of the most beloved pop culture icons of all time. I think that's pretty fair to say about Olivia Newton-John.
I agree.
A career that stretched over decades, that hit multiple audiences. And I was thinking about this the other day. I was talking to my mom, like, because, you know, she was Olivia Newton-John's highlights were kind of a little before my time, and some of them when I was very young. Mm-hmm. Mom, was there ever anything bad said about Olivia Newton-John? Did anybody ever, like, you know, so many stars have this one moment in their history or something. Nothing. Mm-hmm. Nothing. This woman had a flawless career, basically. Was able to touch on TV, movies, TV show, music. Mm-hmm. Like, multi-talented. The definition of a Renaissance woman. Mm-hmm. Wrote a lot of her own lyrics, which a lot of people don't talk about and everything. And out of all of that, maybe the greatest thing she did was towards the end of her days, and as she was fighting cancer, creating the ONJ Cancer Fund, which has raised so much money and awareness to fight cancer. It's the greatest thing she did, and that's saying something.
It is.
That's Olivia, man.
Yeah,
that woman's got a body of work that few will ever have.
Right.
And it's being brought to us by a Chicago-based band and a wonderful artist, Annie Aiello. Annie is one of my favorite interviews I've ever done. She is something.
That was a fun interview, yeah.
So much fun to talk to. Such a giving person. Such a giving of her time. And not only that, but coming to town here to entertain us this Sunday at the Performing Arts Center. And while you're sitting there Sunday taking in this amazing show and being like, my God, does she look and sound so much like Olivia Newton-John? And you get that nostalgia and all those things you love. In the back of your mind or in the front of your heart, you're also going to be able to know, oh, and I just helped cancer research. I just helped raise awareness for cancer. I just helped cancer research. Annie generously donates a portion of her fees to the ONJ Cancer Fund. And the Arts Council is also teaming up with Aspirus to raise funds locally for Women's Cancer Patient Fund.
I mean, that's so
wonderful.
Cool.
It's the definition of a win-win.
Step it up, man. Mm-hmm. I love the way the Arts Council stepped up and did that same thing. It's really cool.
A big thank you to Sally Kistner over at the Arts Council and her whole team over there. Eric Britnocker and his team at the Performing Arts Center. Appreciate them joining us. And a special shout out to Annie for joining us on Midday Magazine. If you'd like a preview of the show, encourage you to listen to that Midday Magazine interview. Wonderful interview. She did a great job. She's something. find your tickets and find out more at SavorTheArts.com. And to also encourage you to check out alwaysoliviatribute.com. There's some wonderful videos on there and other ways that you can find out to raise attention and awareness for this great cancer fund, the ONJ Cancer Fund.
Yep.
Get your tickets and find out more at savorthearts.com or give them a call at 715-424-2787. And, hey, guys, should we give away some tickets?
I think we should.
I mean, it's Friday.
Yes.
I mean,
why not, man? We need to give more stuff away.
Yes, James.
Yeah, you're right. You're right, Melissa. The answer is always yes. 715-424-2600. 424-2600. Call up and give us what's your favorite, either song or movie, like role she played.
Whatever.
Anything. Just even what your favorite things about Olivia Newton-John. That's it. That's all we need.
Yeah, she was in Xanadu.
Oh, nice one. Nice, Seth. Nice. Oh, I forgot about Xanadu. Yeah. Oh, good
weird
one.
Movie.
Weird movie. Very weird movie. Yeah. She was great at that.
But she was good.
She was really good. 715-424-2600. Listening on the Civic Media app. You're just a touch or two away. Call up and win yourself these two tickets to see Always Olivia this Sunday at the Performing Arts Center right here in Wisconsin Rapids. 2 o'clock show. We'll meet you there, everybody. Again, go to SavorTheArts.com to find out more information. We're going to get to our news break. When we come back, we're talking Wisconsin Rapids Community Theaters, The Glass Menagerie, and much more on The Morning Show. Welcome back, everyone. Morning Show here at WFHR. Locally grown radio. Seth, Melissa, and James with you. Having a little Olivia Newton-John playing us in.
Yeah.
Be sure to catch Always Olivia this weekend.
That's right.
2 o'clock this Sunday over at the Performing Arts Center.
It's that's one of the funniest videos ever, by the way.
That is. Yes.
It's hilarious.
It really is. I want to take some time to talk a little bit about a new program that we're going to be premiering this Sunday and talking about some local theater. And this weekend, we're going to be highlighting Wisconsin Rapids Community Theater as they wrap up their winter run of their show, The Glass Menagerie. Mm-hmm. Before we get to that, real quick reminder that they are looking for directors for next season, the 24-25 season. You ever thought you wanted to do something like that? Throw your hat in the ring. Reach out to our friends at WRCT and get involved and be a part of the family, because you will be.
You will be.
You do one thing at WRCT and you will never leave.
Yep. And you will join the group.
And you'll be happy to. You'll be happy to stick around. Mm-hmm. Also, keep in mind, auditions for Rumors are coming up next week, March 11th and 12th, 6:30 at the WRCT Auditorium. If you're curious about what auditioning is or anything, there's Learn More About Auditions tab on their webpage. Encourage you to check out. You can also fill out a little information beforehand if you'd like. And do it. Do it. If you've been on the fence about it, do it. Come on out. Enjoy yourself. Have fun. Theater is meant to be enjoyed, meant to be loved. Art in theater in particular is a mirror to humanity. Mm. And all you got to do is be you. That's it. Jodie Foster had it right when she talked about acting. Acting is about being the most uncool person in the room. It is about being human. And as long as you can be you, you're going to have a great time.
Right.
I encourage you to try. It's also a Neil Simon play.
There's always great fun dialogue and everything like that in there, too. So, yeah.
The Glass Menagerie is wrapping up this weekend. Be sure to catch the shows. They have shows tonight at 7. Tomorrow, they have a 2 o'clock matinee and a 7 o'clock show. Mm-hmm. We will meet you there. I'll be sure to be checking this out. I'm really looking forward to seeing the show. This is bittersweet, I imagine, for you guys. And while it can be, you know, a relief to have your nights back and not to have to memorize lines every day or anything like that, I know that it can be bittersweet. Mel, how are you feeling going into this weekend?
Tired.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
That too, yeah.
And now we're gonna leave Melissa alone the rest of the show, everybody. Yeah. She deserves it.
She's a snooze.
No. Well, I am a little bit tired, yes. But no, this has been phenomenal. It's been the character for me personally, it's been a challenge. Not only just the character itself, but balancing everything. One of my co-stars, Tom, the man who's playing our Tom, Wesley, he asked me, I don't know, maybe it was a conversation we were having. It all melds together. I don't even know. But we were talking about the time commitment that it takes to do theater. And something that just keeps resonating with me is you make the time for the things you enjoy doing. Mm. And that's really what's happened here. Because I am tired. I don't regret doing this. I don't, you know, I'm not like mad about it. Yeah. I'm just tired.
Yeah. No, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
But my little brother, and I say little in, you know, like the vaguest terms, as in he's younger than me. but he came to the show last weekend, and afterwards he's like, "That was impressive, because I know how tired you were."
it's called performance health.
Yeah.
Yes.
When you step on that stage, all of a sudden you find reserves of energy you didn't know you had. Yeah, it's really remarkable.
Mm-hmm. It's a fascinating, and it actually plays really well into my character, because I believe Amanda Wingfield was tired all the time. She was trying so hard to keep her family together, and fighting every step of the way, and fighting with her children to wrangle them into, "No, we are a family. Right. We need to make this work." It's been a joy to be a part of this production, and I hope people come this weekend. And if you want to come for free, Gretchen's looking for ushers.
Mm. Oh,
she just put out a plea for help. Some people had to cancel for tonight, so she's looking for one or two people tonight at 7 and 2 tomorrow at 2. So reach out to Gretchen at the Wisconsin Rapids Community Theater if you want to help out, take a chance, you know, working for us see the show for free.
See the show for free.
Yeah, it's a win-win right there, because ushering's fun.
Yeah,
I enjoy it. I like
it's
doing
easy.
It.
It's easy, not a lot of work, and you just show people seats and stuff. I got to give a shout-out to Melissa, because we had a great reaction last night after the show. We were, you know, wrapping up. Everyone was leaving, and they had their little line of congratulations and everything. And Melissa was about ready to go backstage and get ready to go. And she was stopped by someone, and he had this. It was hilarious, because he had this big smile on his face, and he's like, "You, I hated you," and that was like, "You were awful." And I was like, meaning the character. in that. Yeah. And it's like, and Melissa, tell me, you know, isn't that a great compliment? When you have a character like that, when they say, you know, man, I thought you were, or like one of our other characters is like, you are a jerk or something like that.
Yeah.
That is what you want.
Somebody walked up to him too. Yes. You were a creep.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is what you want, because you know you're playing that character well. Yep. when they have that visceral reaction to, mm-hmm. oh, I hated you.
I have been really fortunate to win some awards, to get some notoriety from some people that I really admire and appreciate. But the greatest, maybe the greatest compliment I've ever gotten as an actor is playing a villain. And my Nana afterwards, she's shaking hands. She's loving the whole cast. She comes up to me and she hesitates to hug me. She holds back for a second and looks at me funny. And as much as that, as much as it hurt for a second, it also felt really,
really good.
Good.
The charge you get from that.
That's something. A big shout out to you and this amazing cast, Melissa. Break mm-hmm. a leg and have a great time. Seth, for you specifically, but you and Beth, I know that this you've spent a longer time with this play, not mm-hmm. only doing it before, but you've been dreaming about doing this particular play this way for years.
Yeah.
So how are you feeling going into this weekend, man?
It's been great. Mm-hmm. I mean, I have to rewind just a little bit for last night. I was, you know, backstage watching the show on the monitors, and Wes was in one of his times where he doesn't, you know, it takes a while to get. So I was asking him basically what Melissa was talking about. I was like, this is his first experience. Mm-hmm. What did you think?
Mm-hmm. Since high school.
Yeah, since high school. You know, what was his reaction? And we talked, you know, a little bit how much work it is and stuff, but he's really enjoyed the process. Mm-hmm. And he asked me the same question. He's like, how about you? Since this is the first time you've directed. And I was like, oh, gosh. And the first thing that popped into my head was like, you know what? It was not as hard as I thought it was going to be because you guys, the cast, worked so hard. You took it so seriously, and you did your line. You did it so well. I mean, it was – for that part, it was – you know, I want to say it was a breeze, but, man, because they took it so seriously, it made it that much easier for Beth and me to get mm-hmm. it through there. The only other thing I got to say is right now, I don't like this part.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I have nothing to do. And I'm just sitting backstage and I'm like, why? What am I doing? Yeah. You know, yeah.
You're a pretty good cheerleader though, Seth.
That's all I have to do. That's all I have left. It's like, good job, everyone. Yay, go out there. And they have. It was a wonderful performance last night. Mm-hmm. So yeah, it's I'm used to being on the other side where it's like you go out there on stage and all that. Mm-hmm. But now it's like, ho hum. You know? Yeah. I'm enjoying the fruits, but at the same time, should I be doing something more? Huh. But this is it's
your
new,
job
so
is
that's
done.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, and I want to share too. We had our line run on Wednesday this week, just to prep for, you know, our night reopening again, and we had a lot of fun. We didn't like get all silly and goofy and stuff. We threw in a couple little things here and there, but we stuck to our lines pretty well. But we did a speed run.
Oh, yeah, that was impressive. Yeah. They really ran right through it, and they did a good job.
You've never heard a Southern accent as fast as I did that night.
That's
because
awesome.
I was like, let's get this done and go home. I'm tired.
Yeah,
exactly.
Oh, that's really cool. I like that. And congratulations, you guys, on a great run and a great weekend. It's going to be really good. It's going to be a really fun time.
Fantastic.
And we encourage everybody to give them a huge crowd, give them a nothing but a great audience for these last three remaining shows. Mm-hmm. Let's show them how much we appreciate them taking time out of their lives, time out of their day-to-days to spend time with us and entertain us.
Yep.
But the best way to say thank you is getting your tickets and showing up to the Glass Menagerie this weekend. Again, shows tonight at 7. Tomorrow they'll have a 2 o'clock matinee and a 7 o'clock show, and that will wrap up the run, everybody.
Get
your tickets and find out more at wrctheater.org, wrctheater.org. And again, have a great run, you guys. Enjoy yourselves.
Yay. Thank you, man.
Thank you. Can I throw out a quick for the Showcase Players, because they open this weekend too for the Lover Best Offer. It's a Wisconsin premiere.
Mm-hmm. I didn't want to put you on the spot, but yes, Melissa, go.
Yeah, no, I had this up. They right have on. Shows on Friday night, Saturday night at 7:30 and a 2 o'clock matinee on Sunday. And then the following weekend, they do the same thing. Their shows start at 7:30 on Friday, Saturday. Tickets are only $10, and it's at the Kobe High School.
Mm-hmm.
So
cool.
I got to see the preview this week of one of their tech rehearsals, and it's great. Cool. Online dating for seniors.
Oh, nice.
You're going to so love great. It. It's so relatable.
Awesome. Oh, my God. That's great. Oh, that's great. Be sure to check that out and support local theater, everybody. Yeah. We appreciate that. Mm-hmm. Real quick, before we go to break, I did want to mention this weekend with our lineup, we've got some great shows for you. Check out the Sunshine Polka Show at 7 tomorrow morning. The best show you'll ever hear. It's a great show.
It's
be sure to check it
it's
out.
Awesome.
We have Over the Back Fence tomorrow. Be sure to join us for that, 11 to noon. Seth will be taking your phone calls with items you're looking for and items you want to sell. Keep calling up on the show, everybody, because that's how we know to keep the show.
Exactly. Might have a few things to give away tomorrow, too.
Yes.
So stay tuned for that.
Uh-huh. Got some tickets to give away. Be listening for that and everything. And, of course, Seth Faces the Music from 6 to 8 every Sunday when we don't have sports to play. Seth, what's your theme this week?
Fire.
Oh, nice. Whoa. I've only fire. One burning desire. Let me stand next to your fire. Nice. Good.
So, yeah, yeah.
It was Burning Ring of Fire going to be played?
Oh,
I'm, you know, I don't remember.
Mm?
This is actually, this is actually one from I did last year, about a year ago. And so I'm throwing a classic episode up there, and I don't remember half the songs I put in.
That's hilarious. I love
I'd have to look at the playlist, but I know.
That's kind of fun to think that you've done so many of these.
Oh, my gosh.
You know, that's
it
really
boggles
cool.
my mind.
It's a real compliment to you and how popular
that
show is.
I've been doing it for 2.5 years.
Yeah, bro.
Two and a half years. I'm like at 70 or 80 episodes. I can't believe it.
People love the show, and it continues to gain in popularity. Keep up the great work with that, and be sure to catch a Best Of episode this weekend of Seth Faces the Music. Fire. And then after that, now normally what we've been doing for over a year now is having our show Director's Cut there, where we feature local talent, local artists, local creatives. We're going to continue to do that show, but the show is going to take a little bit of a hiatus, a little bit of a break as we build up some guests and really get you guys some really great talented people to hear from and for Seth and I to interview. We're going to be doing that, and while we're doing that, well, we're going to have a new show for you.
Yep.
Seth and I over this week decided, you know what, it's time. We've been talking about this. Let's do it. Today, we are going to record and put together the first episode of Unlabeled, your 90s mixtape.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes.
Yeah, it'll be premiering right after Seth Faces the Music. Be sure to join us for that. We're going to do this show for a couple of weeks here, maybe a couple months, while we build up
see
a lineup for Director's Cut. And what it is it's pretty simple, everybody. If a song was released between 1990 and 1999, we'll play it. I'll tell you right now, the first two songs, we're going to go from, this is just a preview for the listeners out there. You're getting a special treat here, a little breaking news. What we'll do is we're going to start off, the first song we're going to play is Smells Like Teen Spirit, go right from that to Regulate.
Yep.
Just to give you a little bit of an idea, it's country, it's pop, it's whatever, we're playing it. If it came out in the 90s, we will play it. One of the things we're going to have fun with that show, a lot of great soundtracks in the 90s. I want to have a soundtrack feature.
Yeah.
We're going to have the best of a class of 93, where we'll take a year and just play songs from that year.
Oh, I'm so excited.
And most importantly, I want your 90s requests.
Yes.
Tell me what you want to hear, and I will play it. If it came out.
Base.
Yeah, I'll play it. I will.
Really?
Yes.
He will do it.
That's the job.
Yeah.
You know, got to play 90s stuff.
Did Loverboy play anything in the 90s?
No.
No.
Thank God. Thank God. That's oh, I do like that rat stuff.
Yeah,
good.
That's very good.
Thank you so much to everybody. You know, I've been teasing this for a while on air, off air, and I've gotten a lot of great feedback from people. People, a lot of excitement about this one.
So, mostly from me prodding him. Come on, let's do this, man. I want to do this. Come on.
Oh, that got me. That was good. And true. And very true. Be sure to join us this weekend and every weekend for Seth Faces Music from 6 to 8 and from 8 to 9, Unlabeled, your 90s mixtape. We're going to have some fun with that one, everybody. And get me your request, james.mailoff@civicmedia.us.
Please.
You can, of course, direct message us on Facebook as well and get those requests that way. Again, as long as it's a song that came out in the 90s, we'll play it.
Mm-hmm.
Even Ace of Base.
Put that out there.
We'll take our final time out of the week. We'll come back and wrap up the show, having some fun on the morning show at WFHR. Welcome back, everyone. Morning show at WFHR.
Yeah!
Welcome back to the show, everyone. Hope you're having a great Friday out there. Thanks for joining us and helping us get ready for the weekend with you. It's been a real fun show.
Good, today. Good one.
Melissa, Seth, and James here with you to wrap things up. And actually, I want to start off the final segment of the week, rewinding a little bit. We were talking and celebrating middle names around here. Mm-hmm. The heart of the station, Pam Hilke, sent us hers.
Okay.
Ooh. Pam says her middle name is Kay. My grandmother's last name started with a K. Pamela Kay is her name.
Oh, very nice.
That's a good name.
I agree.
Yeah, that's a great name.
Of course you would.
That's a very good name.
Well, you know, I took the last name Kay after my mother's middle name. Because her middle name was Kay.
Oh, very cool.
I remember you told me that. That hits. Yeah. That's really beautiful, nice. Melissa. I really like that. And thank you, Pam, for playing along. Thank you to everybody else that played along. We'll continue to celebrate middle names next week. We're also looking for your favorite cereals. Any of our poll questions, quote-unquote poll questions.
They're always open.
Yeah, they're always open, everybody. I want to take a moment to talk about some local things going on, continuing the theme of the hour here. As if you've noticed, we've been really focused on local this hour, and we try to do that as much as we can. Certainly that's our job around here, but on Fridays I really do want to hit that hard. Going forward here with our morning show, we've got so many great local events and local things going on to highlight. The only catch is getting them all in. There's a lot of great things going on, and we know there's a lot of great people out there, and let's be honest on two folds. One, good people don't get noticed nearly enough in this day and age, if ever. And two, we're Midwesterners, and we don't take compliments well. We just do our thing. And that's great. That's wonderful. It's part of what we love about our fellow Midwesterners out there. It also means it's on us to highlight them. And we have a great opportunity for you to do that. Who's your hero?
Yeah.
Join our friends at WAM, who are, of course, a part of Quality Plus Printing, as they are looking for extraordinary individuals to highlight as heroes. Who is the hero in your life? Embrace the joy of celebrating the hero in your life with them. Join them in honoring our exceptional heroes by featuring them in their prestigious Hero High yearbook. And as a token of appreciation, you'll receive a complimentary Hero High t-shirt.
Cool.
Pretty cool. If you have a hero in mind, send them an email explaining why your hero should be recognized for their Hero of the Month. You can do that by emailing them at wamincorporated.com, and that's corporated with a K, so wamincorporated.com at gmail.com. You can do that. You can also direct message them on Facebook. Be a friend of Quality Plus Printing on Facebook, and you can direct message them that way as well. And if you give it to us, we'll make sure they get it. You can email us or direct message us as well. If that's easier, whatever it takes, we'll make sure to get it in the right hands.
Pass it on.
And we'll pass it on.
And I got to tell you quick, I stopped in there yesterday and I got a tour, and it's just such a fun place. Everybody is so friendly, and it was really neat to see all of their equipment there. Wow.
Cool.
Yeah, they've got some great new equipment over there, too. It's really cool.
It's nice. Impressive.
Find out what Quality Plus Printing can do for you, getting your words out here in Wisconsin Rapids. Appreciate our friends over there. And also want to talk about some local stuff going on here. We got some good things happening sports-wise. Pam even updated the sports schedule for us. Shout out to Pam Hilke. She's working her tail off.
She's on it.
This darn playoffs, man. They just ruin everything.
Yeah. As our scheduler, Pam, she sets these things up, and then win or lose, she's got to have two different things kind of set up and everything. And oftentimes she will come in here on the weekends to get things right. There is nobody that works harder in this business than Pam Hilke. And we appreciate her.
Thank you, Pam.
Yeah. She's got our schedule here. Tonight, it's a ball night. Bucks taking on the LA Lakers, 8:30 in LA. That'll be a good one.
It's not as big a woo as it used to be, though.
Tomorrow we got men's hockey as the Badgers hit the ice at 5:30. Be sure to check that out. And Badger basketball this weekend on the men's side at 10:30, and Badgers hockey at 4:30 if needed, if the Badgers keep moving on.
Yep.
We'll talk about this on Playmakers from 3 to 4 this Monday. Be sure to check that out. And speaking of going ahead or looking at our schedule today, one more midday magazine for the week. We're going to welcome in Mike Barnes, director of Indoor Wisconsin Rapids Winter Farmers Market at the Moravian Church. Talk about that. We'll have some others to talk about some great things going on in our Wisconsin Rapids area. Thanks to the Visit Wisconsin Rapids Bureau setting that up for us. Thank you.
Appreciate them.
Yeah. Nice. And in part two, Trent Miner, Wood County Clerk. We're going to talk about the April 2nd election, give you an update on that.
Oh, very nice.
looking forward to it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I, as a side note, again, Pam doing the amazing work she's done, has reached out to every candidate, local candidate, and offered them time on the air. We offer them 10 minutes on the air, and we do give everybody the same amount of time and try to have them on in the same time of day, if you will. And we're going to ask the same questions of every candidate.
Yep.
This isn't a debate. This isn't a conversation. This is me. I ask question. They answer, and we move on.
Yep.
That's the best way to do this, and that is coming from Carl Hilke. And if you got an issue with that, you got an issue with me. That's the way we handle things around here. That's the way WFHR has done things for 80 plus years.
Yep.
We're not changing it for anybody.
No.
That's the right way to do it.
And the point is for the listeners to get to know these candidates.
Exactly. That's the whole point.
We're going to start off with a mayoral candidate, Tom Terry Muse, joining us at 9:35 on Monday. We'll be listening for that. We'll have a good 10 minutes with Tom. We've already talked with Tom once. We'll have him in again and conversate with him and see what he has to say. Looking forward to it. Want to remind everybody as well, daylight savings time, Sunday, 2 o'clock.
No.
I know. God. I'm with you, Melissa.
I'm going to travel to a state where there's no daylight saving times in protest.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
For
I don't
2 weeks.
You.
Yeah, I love it.
Good idea. That's actually, I kind of want to do that myself.
That's why I'm leaving.
Yeah.
Well, I think we have to mention that real quick, James, that it's going to, 2 weeks without Melissa, I don't know, man.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going to happen around here.
I really, I'm a little worried for us.
Yeah, me too.
I'm a little worried for us.
We're coming off the rails already.
Melissa's the glue of the show. She really is. She not only keeps Seth and I from, either laughing all day or destroying each other like that. There are so many things this woman does behind the scenes, you guys, and that you don't even know about. We appreciate her so much and wishing you safe travels.
Yeah.
Enjoy your time,
guys.
Melissa. You have earned
it. Stop making me blush.
Yeah.
We appreciate you so much. And
hey, enjoy. It's the only time I'm saying nice things about you. Yeah, so you come on.
Might want to record
I'm soaking it up, Seth.
Yeah. Let's wrap up with a really big good story of the day, and it's a local one. This must be a popular name for pig owners because another pig named Kevin Bacon is in the news. He went missing in southeast Wisconsin the other day, but police lured him back by using marshmallows.
Oh, a twist. I like that. Marshmallows.
I wouldn't have guessed
but
marshmallows.
It wasn't bacon.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That would have been weird.
A different Kevin Bacon pig got loose in Pennsylvania last month. Last fall and was missing for 17 days, but they did find him.
Yes. How many pigs are named Kevin Bacon? I want to know. I want to know now.
How many days does it take for them to turn feral? Because it's not many.
And how many degrees of separation are there from these pigs from another pig?
From Kevin Bacon.
Thank you for a great week. We appreciate the best listeners in radio. Be good to each other. Melissa, have a great break, and we'll talk to you soon, okay?
Thanks. Have fun, guys.
Have a great run this weekend, you guys. Enjoy the Glass Menagerie. Enjoy and support your River Kings this weekend as well, everybody. We will talk to you soon and later right here at...
This is locally grown radio. WFHR 1320 AM. W248 DE Wisconsin Rapids. And always streaming on the Civic Media app.